I can't stand, you know, if they took it, if judges take it, hey, I shouldn't have let y'all have the outcome. Okay, I accept it. That's kind of what I teach my guys, man. We don't care. If you can't take it on the chin, man, that's why I'm so disappointed with Deontay, bro. It's you know, I mean, and I was at least hoping, bro, would you please explain to people? You can't box with your hand, not in your gloves, bro. I don't get that, man. And I'm like, he could just say, y'all, I get it. Y'all my fans. I appreciate y'all. We gonna get in shape and try it again. But that nonsense, bro, you just muddling the waters with that, bro. That's disappointing for me, man.
Right. But look, all right, look, in defense of Deontay Wilder a little bit. Not even in defense of Deontay Wilder, but all right, so I saw some videos. Now, I'm not saying no glove, none of that stuff. I'm not even saying none of that stuff, like, that happened with the gloves. The video did look kind of convincing. His hand was out.
That Slim's ass hand? How he slaps them jabs and shit.
It looked like his hand was out. You know, that was kind of convincing. But a lot of people don't realize, like, and I read a book about it. People see my book collection. I read every book on that shelf, matter of fact. But so I read a book about it, and they were saying, like, how athletes, you got to realize, like, sometimes as an athlete, when you give it everything you got, you in training camp for 6 to 8 weeks, you busting your ass every single day, and you and somebody beat you, right? And you lose. For the human mind, most of the time, it gotta be a reason why I lost. You know what I'm saying? So that's why a lot of people try to give excuse. They be like, this is why, this is the reason, this is the reason. Because they can't accept, they be like, you know, they really can't accept to her, like, how did I lose? I did everything
like a self
in training camp and I lost. So it's, you know, a lot of people gotta give. Be like, oh, I lost because of this reason. Oh, the suit was heavy in this, you know. So it's a human thing, you know. Like, you just imagine anybody. You give everything you got, and then you don't succeed. And then you gotta have something in your head. Be like, this is why I didn't succeed, you know. So it's, for me, I think it's a human thing. I think it's definitely human nature. Of course, like Deontay Wilder saying the suit. Of course, it is an excuse. It's definitely an excuse. You should never. Maybe it did suck up your legs. Maybe it did zap your energy or whatever. Maybe not. We don't know. But as a human, you got to think, like, I lost because of this. That's why a lot of people think. You know what I'm saying?
Like a self-preservation, like a defense mechanism, an explanation.
It is. You know, basically, it is. You know what I'm saying? That's kind of how it is as an athlete. Now, of course, you still go back and, you know what I'm saying?
You still go back and
do your homework and then get better from that. But, you know, don't wear the suit again. Don't do this. Don't do that. You know, when the next fight happens, he'll have to do all that stuff and take all those precautions. But, you know, as an athlete, I mean, that's, you'll think like, all right, I lost because of this. I gave everything I had and I had to lose because of this reason. And that's kind of, you know, that's kind of how it is.
It just worries me because here's the other side of that. Like, how you going to get back in the gym, bro, and do some adjustments? Regardless if you can or can't, that's, you know, that's for the fans. And then we'll see when they fight.
Right.
But, you know, you got to tell yourself, what's the things I got to fix, man, and do different? Because if you ain't accepting that part of it, it's like, man, you bound to repeat the shit.
Right. That's what I'm saying. He got to do that. He has to, of course, he can make the excuses and stuff, but he has to go in the gym and fix
it. Be honest with yourself.
Yeah, you got to be honest with yourself and be like, all right, maybe my suit was heavy. Maybe he was punching, but I didn't do this right. You know what I mean?
Right.
You go back and you fix that. That's what he has to do. You know, so you can, it goes both ways.
Absolutely, man. I just be interested in seeing how boys bounce back, because one of the things I tell everybody, man, and I say, listen, man, Joe Lewis lost, bro. Joe Lewis got knocked out before he ever became the heavyweight champion of the world. Right. And so if Joe Lewis could lose, what you think? You know what I'm saying? That could happen.
Right. Yeah, I mean, listen, bro, like, I think everybody right now is so concerned with the zero because of Floyd. You know what I'm saying? Floyd.
Right. He
emphasized that zero so much. So now fighters, you know, they're scared to take chances and they don't want to fight hard fights because they're scared to lose that zero. But for me, it don't matter about me. First off, like I said, I'm gonna keep saying this until the day I die. I thought I won the fight, so for me, it's not even about the win or loss. Of course, I got the one on the other end of my record, but I still thought I won the fight. But for me, it's all about now. How are you gonna come back? You know what I'm saying? That's what it's all about for me. And all my idols lost, all of them.